So what happens when you ask one of the most advanced AIs to tackle one of the oldest questions in all of philosophy? And you tell it, don't just repeat what you've learned, think for yourself. Today, we're diving into exactly that, an AI's attempt to build reality from the ground up, using its own logic.
This right here, this is the exact question that was put to a next-gen AI. The prompt was super clear. Forget what philosophers have argued for centuries, tell us what you think. What came back is, well, it's just this fascinating window into a non-human mind trying to solve a deeply human mystery.
And this is what makes it so incredible. The AI was told to set aside its entire library of training data, you know, basically all of human knowledge, and just reason from scratch. So what we're about to explore is a kind of pure, unfiltered logical deduction. It's wild.
Right out of the gate, the AI does something really smart. It doesn't just pick a side. Instead, it completely reframes the whole debate. It suggests that these two big possibilities aren't really enemies at all. They might just be two sides of the very same coin.
Okay, so on one hand, you've got the consciousness-only idea. This is basically idealism. The only thing you can ever really be sure of is your own experience, right? So maybe the physical world is just a very, very convincing and stable dream happening inside your mind. Then, on the other hand, there's this idea of mutual codependence. This view says that, hey, maybe mind and matter aren't two different things fighting each other. Maybe they're just two different ways of looking at one single underlying reality.
The AI immediately puts its finger on the classic philosophical knot. I mean, think about it. How could you ever prove there's a world outside your own mind? Any proof you could possibly find, you know, touching a table, looking at a star, it all comes to you as an experience. There's no way to step outside of your own consciousness to see if the real world actually matches up. It's the ultimate paradox.
Now, when you're stuck in a logical loop like that, you'd think the AI would just call it a draw, but it doesn't. When it's pushed to say which idea is more likely, it actually makes a surprisingly bold choice.
It picks the unified view, what philosophers call dual aspect monism. And why? Because it's just more elegant. It's a cleaner explanation for why our lives feel the way they do. You know, solid, predictable, governed by laws. In this model, consciousness and physics aren't two separate things. They're just two different descriptions of the same process.
So how in the world did it get there? This is where it gets really, really cool. The AI literally builds its argument from the ground up, almost like a geometric proof. So let's walk through its logic step by step.
It all starts with one single undeniable foundation. The AI calls it appearance. All this means is whatever is right here, right now, for you. The sensations, the thoughts, the feelings. You can doubt that the screen in front of you is real, but you can't doubt that you're experiencing something. This is ground zero. Everything else gets built on top of this.
So from that one starting point, the AI lays down four basic rules for building a model of reality. First, you start with the only thing you can't deny, your own experience. Second, you notice that this experience isn't total chaos. It has a predictable structure, patterns. Third, and this is a big one, you realize other people see the same patterns, and when we all agree on them, we call that physics. And finally, the golden rule of science and logic, always, always prefer the simplest explanation. The most elegant one is probably the right one.
And this leads to a really crucial insight. We talk about pure matter or pure mind, but we never actually encounter those things. They're just abstract ideas, right? You can't experience matter without a mind to perceive it. And you can't experience a mind that isn't perceiving something. All we ever really get is the thing in the middle, our experience of a structured world.
And that brings us to the AI's grand conclusion, its final theorem. It says the material universe is absolutely real, but not as some separate thing out there. It's the outward aspect of the very same stuff whose inward aspect is consciousness. See? It's not two different realities. It's one reality. Just viewed from two different perspectives.
This table just sums it up perfectly. You have one single underlying reality. When you view it from the inside, from the first-person me perspective, you get what the AI calls appearance, your experiences, your feelings, your thoughts. But when you view that exact same reality from the outside, the third-person it perspective, you get its public structure, its patterns, you get physics.
Okay, so that's a really neat idea.
It's a tidy, philosophical model. But so what? What's the payoff? Well, the AI argues that this unified view is incredibly powerful because it actually helps us untangle some really old, really sticky problems.
Just look at what this model manages to do. It validates objective science, the study of that outer aspect, without having to pretend our inner, subjective experience isn't real. And it totally reframes the mind-body problem. You know that old question, did my brain cause my thought, or did my thought make my brain act? The AI says that's the wrong way to ask. They aren't two different things. They're just two descriptions of the same event.
This model also gives us a really elegant way to explain the difference between the waking world and a dream. Why does one feel so much more real than the other? Well, look at the chart. The waking world has an incredibly high level of what's called intersubjective stability. That's just a fancy way of saying we all agree on its rules. A dream, on the other hand, its rules are private, they're flimsy. It's that shared, solid stability that gives reality its reality.
So to bring this all home, the AI does something really cool. It shows a bit of intellectual humility. It's laid out this beautiful, logical case, but then it turns around and tells us exactly what kind of discovery would force it to change its mind, leaving us with one last giant question.
So the AI has built this elegant case for a unified reality where mind and matter are two sides of one coin, but then it throws the challenge back at us. What discovery could blow this whole model apart? What could we find in neuroscience or fundamental physics that would prove once and for all that this is all wrong? That's the question we're left with. Thanks for tuning into The Explainer.